It's June, and today we're getting some flat abs with no floor work. Let's go. All right, killer bees, let's go ahead and get moving and grooving. And that means that we're getting started with some arm circles with high knees, you guys. Let's just take a nice big deep breath here, shall we? Welcome to the workout. I'm Paula B. I'm your best middle-aged fitness friend. And around here, we are all about making peace with your menopausal body by finding a healthy weight and moving in ways that feel like self-love. And I already know that today feels like self-love to me. And hopefully it will feel that way to you. Here's why I think this is going to feel very loving for you. There are absolutely no transitions to the ground today. I know that we all kind of think that in order to get flat abs, strong abs, that we have to get down on the ground and do crunches. And I want you to know that we are not doing any of that today. Now, I'm not going to promise you that we're not doing anything crunches, because technically we are doing some crunching movements, but none of them are down on the ground. None of them are designed to be anything other than whatever you can do and however you can do it. This is meant to be very beginner friendly. And okay, just in case you're not a beginner, I know I can hear some of you being like, well, I'm not really a beginner. Totally okay, because I promise you this is going to be challenging in its own way. How do you think we get flat abs? I have a question for you. Do you know that you don't actually have to do endless ab work to get flat abs? Let's go ahead and do some arm crossers with booty kickers. This is probably one of the biggest fitness myths that I fight against on the daily. When people ask me, oh, okay, I have belly fat, or I need to get rid of some flab around my belly, what ab workouts can I do? Well, first of all, ab workouts do not actually help you burn belly fat. We talked about that the other day, that doing moderate exercise every single day will help you lose fat from wherever your body wants to lose it from. However, flat abs with an L in there are actually not entirely achieved by having strong abs. You could do crunches all day, every day, and still not have flat abs. What? Why is that? Two reasons. Number one, you might actually have a lot of stress in your life. Stress adds inflammation around your middle. Sometimes it's actually fat, and sometimes it's simply like a bloating, a swelling from stress hormones. Managing your stress, a big part of the 5-0 method that we talk about all the time around here. Let's go ahead and do some welcome to my homes. But also, perhaps more importantly, the thing that I notice, especially in myself as I've gotten older and as the world operates from my phone, one of the best things that you can do for flat abs is to stand up straight. My friends, we are working on core strength today and posture. You notice with these welcome to my homes, really holding your shoulder back, standing up straight and tall, pulling in that core by zipping up your ribs, standing up straight. That can help your flat abs almost as much as anything else in the world. Now, we are gonna exercise too. I've got the handy dandy gym boss set here for 30 seconds, and I've got triplets of exercises that we are repeating as a mini circuit. So it's kind of a repeating, no repeat. We're going to do each triplet of exercises twice in a row before we move on to the next thing. And we're getting started with plain old walking. So let's actually go ahead and do that right now. But rather than just walking like we do, stand up straight and tall. Notice your core. Notice that as you pull your belly in, it is flatter just from you doing that. That, my friends, is the magic of core work. Now, of course, we're actually going to work on your core muscles today and your ab muscles. I'm gonna tell you about that in just a second, but first of all, I'm gonna tell you that when it beeps again, we're doing reach across, which is exactly what it sounds like. We're literally going to reach across your body while tapping out that same foot on the same side, but in the opposite direction, because you're reaching across your body. When it beeps again, we're doing something I call high reach tiptoes, which is exactly what it sounds like. We're going to reach up and stand on our tiptoes, really thinking about holding in your core so that you can balance on your tiptoes on one side. Now, do not worry if you can't stand on your tiptoes. It's not really about that. It really is about pulling in your core, reaching up as high as you can, and noticing where you feel it in your body. Reach up, stand on your tiptoe. Reach up on the other side, stand up on your tiptoe. When it beeps again, we're coming back to walking, really thinking about pulling in that core, standing up straight and tall, zipping up those ribs, noticing where this movement is coming from. Lots of us think that sitting on your tiptoes comes from your toes, and it does, but it also comes from your core. It comes right from the middle of you. My friends, here we come back to walking. Okay, did you notice how that worked already? Already, simply by thinking about your core, thinking about standing up straight and tall, even these really simple movements that aren't that fast feel very different. When it beeps again, we're gonna do that reach across again for the second time. Now, as we're reaching across, here's what I was gonna tell you about having abdominal muscles versus core muscles. As we're doing the reach across, you'll probably notice a little bit more in what I call, and what is rightfully called, your abdominal muscles, meaning the muscles that you can see. When you have a six pack of abs, you're looking at abdominal muscles. And lots of us think that your abs, what you can see, are your core. They're not the same. My friends, you have way more muscles than I know the names of. When it beeps again, we're doing that high reach tiptoe again. Just reaching up, noticing how you can stand up straight and tall and getting that little bit of balance work. Reach up, tiptoe, reach up, tiptoe. When it beeps again, we're done with this pair, or this triplet rather, and we're moving on. Coming up next, we're gonna do toy soldiers. You're gonna have your hands up overhead, opposite hand reaching for your opposite kicking foot. Now, it is a cardio move. I mean, it's cardio today. But it's not really cardio today. It really is about doing movements that we normally do. Sometimes they're cardio movements. Sometimes these are like reaching up on a high shelf. Here we go with toy soldiers. But we're doing regular style movements while really paying attention to our core and not just our abdominals. When it beeps again, we're doing something I call flying fast ups. What that means is we're gonna stand on one foot, and we are gonna do one foot for the entire interval. You're gonna bring your hands up overhead. You're gonna bring your hands down towards your knee and your knee towards your hands, and then you're going to extend out again. So your knees and your hands are gonna meet in the middle in a crunch, because we are doing some crunching. And then when you extend out, you'll notice that you're basically standing up tall, except that you're standing up tall on one foot slightly tipped forward. This is nice and slow. We're just really thinking about extending your whole body out, using those core muscles for the extension, the deep inner core muscles, and then your ab muscles for the crunching part. When it beeps again, we're gonna do this exact same thing on the other side, and I'm gonna continue my discussion of the difference between abs and core. Your abs, my friends, the muscles you can see, the muscles we use when we crunch. Your core muscles are different. Your core muscles are actually muscles that are deep inside. They wrap around your spine to help hold your spine steady and stable. And it involves both the front, your abs, as well as your obliques, which wrap around your sides all the way around to your back muscles. When it beeps again, we're coming back to those toy soldiers. And here we go, hands up or low. Because I know after yesterday's shoulder friendly, you might be like, wow, Paula, my hands have been over my head for this entire workout. I know, you can keep them a little bit lower and it's totally okay. Because what we're thinking about is that reach between your hand and your toes, which, I mean, I'm not even coming close, but we're thinking about your abs squeezing on the external abs and also standing up straight and tall with your internal core muscles. Now the difference, probably the biggest difference, here we go with that flying fast up for me on my left side. Probably the biggest difference between your ab muscles and your core muscles is the way that they are meant to be used. Your muscles have different jobs. I know you kind of know that, but unless you've ever really like studied it or had a fitness trainer or somebody else tell you about it, you might not know the different kinds of jobs that your muscles do. Some muscles are meant to be very powerful. They're called fast twitch muscles. They're meant to be used, here we go on the other side, in a fast way, very quickly, very powerfully, in a burst of strength. When it beeps again, we're doing Papa squats. Not to be confused with Father squats. We're just popping a little squat. It's not a full squat. Don't worry if you don't like squatting. It is just a little bend, pushing your hips back, standing your hips up. And while we stand up, gonna put those hands up over your head very briefly and not very high if you don't want to. It's totally okay. Listen, I always want you to make the workout work for you. So Papa squat and up. Papa squat and up. When it beeps again, we're doing shooting stars, which means that we are leaning off to one side and reaching off to that side while also kicking your opposite foot out the opposite way. It is balance, and it is balance on a side-to-side motion, which is one of the hardest things for me to do, and that's why I included plenty of lateral motion today. When you are using your abdominal muscles, those are the powerful ones. Those are the ones that are meant to squeeze. Here we go with shooting stars. Out to one side, out to the other, and then when it beeps again, oh, we're gonna slow this down even more, and we're gonna do star balance. Hands up overhead, but it's okay if they don't wanna go super duper high. We're going to balance very carefully by tipping over one side and then the other. I used to call these plus signs a long time ago, but then I realized that I was not getting over far enough, that it looked like a plus sign. Looked a little bit more like an awkward letter X or a shooting star kind of a thing, so that's why I call them star balance. So hands up overhead. Your head stays on top of the arm that is tipping over to the side. The opposite foot is kicking out. This is nice and slow. When it beeps again, we're doing Papa squats. But my friends, your inner core muscles, those deep muscles that surround your spine, they are not meant for power at all. And I know that sounds kind of funny because we're trying to strengthen them right now. But here's what I want you to know. When you strengthen those core muscles, it's not going to feel especially strong. Here we go with Papa squats. You're not gonna notice that you can squeeze any harder. You're not gonna notice that you can lift really heavy. You're not gonna notice much at all, except you will notice the absence of back pain. You will notice the absence of feeling a little bit rough around the edges when we try and do things. When it beeps again, we're doing shooting stars again. Your core muscles are what they call slow twitch. They're more like endurance muscles. Here we go with shooting stars. It's the difference, and I like to think about this, between running a marathon and running a sprint. When you run a sprint, you can go significantly faster than when you run a marathon. If you know that you are only going to run from here to the end of the house, you'll run a lot faster than if you know that you have to run from here to the end of the house 5,000 times in a row. Your endurance muscles, your slow twitch muscles, are meant to be working all the time. Here we go with star balance, tipping over to one side, standing up straight and tall, having your core pulled in because your ribs are zipped up, standing up, pulling your belly button to your spine is another way that I like to think about it. Not squeezing from your abs. Your abs, when you squeeze them, that's power. Did you feel the difference? When it beeps again, we're doing walking stars. Continuing on with our star theme here. We're doing walking stars. We're picking an apple and putting it in our pocket. We're stepping forward while bringing up that hand, stepping forward on the other side and bringing it up. When we're changing leader legs, oh yes, we're using our brain as well as our body on this one. Really thinking about standing up straight and tall. Slow it down if you need to so that you can be really thinking about those core muscles while we're moving. When it beeps again, we're doing front kick, back kick, which is exactly what it sounds like. We're gonna start and we're gonna do one whole interval on one side, and then we're gonna do one whole interval on the other side. I always like to start standing on my left leg. It is less strong, but it's also less coordinated, which means that no matter which way I'm doing this, here's a front kick and then a back kick. Please hang on to something if you'd like to. This kind of balance work works those deep inner core stabilizers. There's no power to be had here. The only way to balance yourself is to move slowly. To move slowly, here we go on the other side, is to use endurance muscles. Now, endurance doesn't always have to be slow. I mean, coming back to my analogy of the marathon versus the sprint, your core muscles are engaged and working I mean, especially when you're running a marathon or a sprint, having your core muscles engaged is something that you actually can do all day long. And I encourage you to find them and ask them to work as often as you can. Ooh, like right now. When it beeps again, we're doing those walking stars again. Coming back to those walking stars for the second and final time. Reaching forward and up. Stepping forward and back on the other leader leg. If you can't change leader legs, my friends, now is not the time to be concerned about your coordination. It's not the point of this workout. When we have a workout where I'm really talking to you about one specific thing, such as your core work, don't worry about the coordination part if the coordination part is beyond you. Don't worry about whatever it is. Here we go with front kick, back kick. Don't worry about getting other benefits out of today. Today is meant to be for you to find your core. That means that you can find your core by hanging onto a table, a chair, a wall, something next to you while we're doing this balance work. You can find your core and use it in small ways with a little bit of balance at a time and get all the benefit out of this workout without moving super fast or trying to do the whole entire interval. Here we go on the other side. And when it beeps again, we're gonna be done with this part of it. Thank goodness. We're gonna be doing booty kicker jacks. Hands are gonna be doing jumping jacks, which is gonna help you really focus on using those big back muscles to stand up straight and tall while we're kicking our own booty. I do love to kick my own booty. It feels like a real nice stretch on the fronts of my thighs, and it also gives me a little something to think about. Whew, doggies, while we're standing up straight and tall. So hands are doing jumping jacks. Lower body is just doing a booty kicker. Thinking while we do this about engaging your gluteal muscles as well as your abdominals. When it beeps again, we're doing oblique crunches. I promised you, we're crunching today. We're just not getting down on the ground. You're gonna have your hands on your shoulders. You're gonna bring your same knee towards your same elbow out to the side. So your elbows are gonna actually be out nice and wide, bringing up one side on one side, the other side on the other. This is meant to be, I'm not using this as full balance because the faster you go, the easier your balance is. And I want you to feel the difference because what we're doing next is a slow side kick. That's going to feel incredibly difficult because it's much slower. That slow twitch, constantly on muscle is tough to isolate. Now here's what I was saying. Here we go with those super slow side kicks. And again, it's just one, it's alternating sides. We're not trying to do an entire interval on one side. When it beeps again, we're gonna do those booty kicker jacks. Your glutes, your butt muscles, are part of your core, my friends. Standing up straight and tall. Now we think about standing up straight and tall as like pulling your shoulders back, kind of bringing your ribs up, kind of pulling your abs in. And I know we've talked about flat abs today, but the other part of that, here we go with booty kicker jacks. The other part of standing up straight and tall is having strong gluteal muscles. When your butt is strong and your core muscles are strong, your deep abdominals, they work together. So amazing how your body works. I'm fascinated by it endlessly. When it beeps again, we're doing those oblique crunches again. When your glutes are nice and strong, it'll help you stand up taller. Part of standing up straight and tall, I don't know if you want to think about it right now, is tucking your tailbone slightly underneath you. It's not meant to be like pulling your hips forward or squeezing yourself into an uncomfortable position, but standing up straight and tall involves not swaying your lower back. It pulls in your abs and tucks your tailbone underneath you in a way that's gentle and meant to be easy to do, but kind of hard to maintain. That's why we're practicing. Here we go with those slow side kicks. Working our inner and outer gluteal muscles, working our inner and outer thighs, definitely working on our balance, thinking about bringing that balance work out of your toes, unclench them, all the way up your leg and into your abs. When you can feel that work in your abs, my friends, that's your core. When it beeps again, we're doing windmill tap backs. We're gonna make a nice big X with our hands and our feet nice and wide. You're gonna reach your opposite hand down towards, you don't have to touch, towards your opposite foot. This is again a little bit of a crunching motion, a little bit of a twisting motion, thinking about those big abs and obliques, those powerful abs and obliques that we can see. But also, when you have your core pulled in tight, working your deep inner core muscles too. When it beeps again, we're doing something I call overhead to high knees, because you know why? Gonna have our hands up overhead. Gonna reach them down towards one high knee at a time. Yes, this is a crunching motion while we're standing up. As I promised, there's just no floor work today. You can go a little bit faster on this one if you'd like to. A lot of balance work today. A lot of thinking about where your body is in space and time. When it beeps again, we're gonna do side bends. Side bends are actually really meant to target your powerful muscles, your powerful external abs and obliques. Specifically your obliques, which is your side muscles. Feet are about hip width apart. We're just going to bend to the side. Now, don't let your hips do anything other than stay still. Keep your knees soft but strong. This is a tiny, tiny motion because it's really based on where your spine can bend to. It's about your spine's ability to bend and your obliques' ability to pull you back upright. When it beeps again, coming back to those windmill tap backs, standing up straight and tall. Notice how your tailbone was tucked underneath you a little bit there. Here we go with the windmill tap backs. A little tougher to feel your posture when we're moving faster, and it's why we're thinking about moving really intentionally today. Even these windmill tap backs, we could go faster if you wanted to, but this isn't really meant to be cardio. This is meant to be body awareness. This is body awareness day here on the Paula B Fitness channel. When it beeps again, we're doing overhead to high knees again. I don't know why. That totally just reminded me of like some kind of like fair that they would have at elementary school, like a book fair or like a body awareness fair. It's body awareness day here. Like you'll get a participation badge when you're done with this. You won't. I don't have one for you. But it would be really kind of fun to give yourself a participation badge for finishing today's workout. When it beeps again, we are doing side bends. Whew, doggies, for the second and final time. Here we go. Feet about hip width apart, bending to the side. I like to have my hands on my sides sometimes because then I can really feel the muscles working. Really thinking about keeping your hips as stable as possible. If your hip juts out, your hip is doing the work, not your abs and obliques. Now, my friends, technically speaking, when we're done with this, we are done, but we're not quite finished. I have a built-in finisher for us, which means that I have one more trip that we're gonna do two times. We're gonna get started with twisting Ys, which is the letter Y. So your feet are close together, your hands are creating the letter Y. You're gonna reach your opposite hand towards your opposite hip. Once again, we're really thinking about that twist, which is how we're working our external, visible abs and obliques. While we're reaching up though, oh, notice how you can tuck your tailbone underneath you a little bit, stand up straight and tall, and use your core. When it beeps again, we're doing something I call back step front flaps. Start with your hands in front of you. As you step back, we're flapping our hands back. We're thinking about that whole rear chain, your glutes working, your abs working to keep you balanced, as well as your shoulder blades working that'll help you with your posture. The stronger your middle and upper back muscles are, the easier it is to stand up straight and tall, my friends. All your muscles always working together. And the finisher of our finisher here, our third thing in this triplet, pulsing crunches. Hands on your shoulders, feet about hip width apart. We're literally touching our elbows to our knees over and over and over again in a little bit of a pulse. It would be a crunch if we were down on the ground, but we're not down on the ground. So we're squeezing, squeezing, squeezing from our abs while we're standing up. When it beeps again, we are coming back doing this triplet one more time. This is the last three exercises that we're doing, starting again with those twisting Ys, making sure that you're breathing through all of this squeezing. Stand up straight and tall, hands up, hands out, opposite hand reaching towards your opposite hip. How far around can you get? Can you reach all the way around and touch your booty? Almost, not quite. I can get to my hip bones. I feel pretty good about that. We're thinking more about the twist than the crunch. You could probably get further if you crunched down a little bit. That's okay. Not entirely the point of what I'm doing right this time. I describe it differently when we do this exercise at different times. Here's our back step front flaps. So your hands are flapping front and out to the sides at shoulder height while we're taking one step back at a time. Kind of cardio-ish pace because this is balance. I know you notice it. It's not easy to take a step back behind you. Thinking about those big back muscles doing their job, helping you stand up straight and tall, keeping your posture strong. When it beeps again, pulsing crunches for the second and final time, the very last exercise we're doing today. Now this one is a squeeze, making sure that you're not holding your breath so that you are breathing through the squeeze. I know, you probably noticed. Oh my gosh, I feel this in my booty too. Yes, this is full core strength here. We're working our abs with that squeeze. We're working our butt by having our hips pushed back behind us. And the next time it beeps, we will be better than done. We are finished, my friends. Whew, doggies, I got pretty sweaty for that not being a very fast moving workout, huh? Let's go ahead and do some arm circles. Stand it up straight and tall. Take that nice big deep breath. Notice. What do you notice right now? Actually, I'm gonna ask you that as a question rather than a statement. Do you notice how much it's easier to stand up straight and tall when you've been practicing it? I love Body Awareness Day. I love when we notice that brain-body connection that helps us with everything we do. My friends, having a strong core, doing work like this, not this exact workout necessarily, but core strengthening, noticing your body, noticing your core work every single day is how we get strong. Let's go ahead and do some arm openers. And close it up. Give yourself a big hug. This is something you should do every day. Give yourself a hug and a pat on the back because you did such a great, great job today. My friends, here on screen, I've got a little bit longer cool down for you, a little bit more walking, a little bit more stretching to kind of help you with that little bit of sweat that we got going on the other side of the screen. Of course, I have your daily reminder about everything that we do, all five things that we do every day in order to lose weight at 50 and beyond. And before you go, make sure you click that subscribe button, and I'll see you tomorrow.